But first tonight to our top story. In both sides of the simmering conflict have military hardware on the move now. South Korean intelligence claims the North is relocating middle-range missiles, while the United States is moving an advanced defence system to protect a potential target in the Pacific Ocean. Amid the rising tension, Canberra is making contingency plans to ensure the safety of Australians in Seoul. Lachlan Kennedy reports.
The latest images from a propaganda machine that has what it wants: global attention. North Korean TV today broadcasting this anti-American rally, a demonstration of strength in numbers. What the vision didn't show, though, are these Musudan-class missiles, featured in past rallies and unveiled in 2010. American and South Korean intelligence believes the North is repositioning one to its coastline. This deployment has the number crunchers hard at work. Analysts calculate the missile may have a range up to 4,000 kilometres. If that's accurate, the island of Guam, an unincorporated American territory, may now be a target. The Pentagon will move an advanced ballistic missile defence system to Guam in the coming weeks.
A real and clear danger and threat.
The mid-range missile is also of significant concern to Japan. The country's chief cabinet secretary declaring it will not be pushed around by North Korea's provocations. But provocation may be all this is. It's unclear whether Musudan missiles have ever been tested, and there's significant disagreement over how many the North actually has. Regardless, on a day the North declared its military had approval to launch a nuclear attack, the United States is not willing to take a chance.
It only takes being wrong once. And I don't want to be the Secretary of Defense who was wrong once.
On the border, South Korean workers and trucks are still being turned around. The shared Kaesong Business Park off-limits for a second day. As employees protest, Australia is pushing for Chinese intervention.
We're looking at additional sanctions on North Korea to send a powerful message.
Germany has now also weighed in, calling on China to help control the North's aggression.
Well, joining me now for analysis is global security expert and director of the Griffith Asia Institute, Professor Andrew O'Neill. Professor, with the repositioning of this mid-range missile, the rhetoric has become action. What do we know about this weapon and its capability?
We know that this is a missile that's capable of striking a range of targets throughout the region, including all of Japan, obviously coverage of South Korea, the entire Korean Peninsula, but significantly from the point of view of the international audience, this is a missile that that is capable of reaching Guam in the Pacific, which of course is one of the biggest US military bases in Asia.
The US is obviously scrutinising by satellite every move the North Koreans make. The movement of this missile was obvious, deliberately so. I guess a bigger concern, though, is what's not being signposted.
What's significant in all of this is that the Americans, the South Koreans, the Japanese and allies with whom they interact, including Australia, will be very interested in the sorts of things that the North Koreans don't want us, don't want the international community to know about. So, for example, US satellites will be closely monitoring visual cues of the movement of military equipment, the mobilisation of forces, any evidence of communications traffic that demonstrates a kind of heightened level of alert. And more ominous kind of developments like the fueling of missiles, the transport of missiles from underground facilities to actual launching pads.
On state TV today, North Koreans were told the moment of explosion is approaching and fast. Just how likely is it that this is going to devolve into all-out war?
Look, that's a very difficult question to ask. I think it would depend on a range of things occurring. For whatever reason, the regime does move to a higher state of military alert. It does start to look at mobilising its military capability. I think that would be a really critical point, because at that point, the US and the South Koreans would be very close to initiating a preemptive or preventive strike on these North Korean assets. And I think if you have that situation occurring, it will be very difficult to control the subsequent process of escalation.
Professor, you spoke there about the rolling out of missiles, if indeed it comes to that. What do we know about their arsenal, their stockpile, if you like? How many of these missiles do they have?
And we tend to focus on the nuclear aspect, but North Korea's arsenal is primarily conventional in its makeup. We know that it targets key cities in South Korea. For example, Seoul, the capital of South Korea, we know that the North Koreans could unleash 500,000 rounds of artillery strikes per hour in the opening hours of any conflict that would essentially lay waste to large areas of one of Asia's biggest metropolitan centres.
Professor Andrew O'Neill, thanks very much for your time.
Thanks very much.